not a private limited company, then automatically that is public limited company only. Then the second feature it is the paid up capital, the minimum paid up capital. Paid up capital of a public limited company is minimum of 5 lakh rupees. This is second feature. Then the with respect to number of members, the minimum number of members it is 7, but maximum number of members unlimited. There is no limit in case of public limited companies. Then this is one of the best points, free to transfer the shares. Free to transfer the shares, but it is not possible in case of private company. But here it is very free to transfer the shares. Then the last point, it is at the end of the name of the company, one should write limited. So these five are the features of public limited company. Then the best one, the very important one is OPC, one person company. This is the concept newly introduced in the Companies Act, OPC, one person company. For this also, what are the features of OPC, one person company? Natural persons, only natural persons can start this kind of companies. This is first one, only the natural persons. Then the second one is one person can start only one OPC. That means one person, suppose if I am there, if I am starting one company in Andhra Pradesh, I am not supposed to start such kind of companies anywhere in the universe. That is the meaning of this one. Then the person should be natural person only. This is the second feature. Then third one is, generally in case of other companies, in case of private company or in case of public limited company, you can start your company for charitable purposes also. That means the company, the amount of the company may be profit, the amount of the company may be the non-profit. But here, you are not supposed to start such kind of offices, not for what's called charitable purposes. That means exclusively. This is only for business purpose only. OPCs are established only for the purpose of business only. Then the capital of the OPC is 50 lakhs, not more than 50 lakhs. That means it should not exceed 50 lakhs of its capital. Then the next, last feature of this OPC is the average turnover of the 3 years of the company should not exceed 2 crores rupees. That means, say I started my business in 2007, then in 2007, 2008, 2009, average my turnover, that means my sales should not exceed 2 crores rupees. This is one more best feature of the OPC. Then, sixth point, This is also called as nominal capital. This is also called as registered capital. Then what do you mean called as capital? This is the capital to be issued throughout the lifespan of a company. That is, this is the maximum amount of the company. So suppose in this year, say in the 2020, I want to start a business, say 10 crores rupees. Then if after completion of say 2 years, if I want to move 5 crores to the same business, again after completion of 3 crores, if I want to add say 10 crores, that means after completion of total 5 years, my capital will be 25 crores. If I am staying in other capital as 10 crores, that means I am not supposed to reissue the shares more than this 10 crores. That means whatever the amount mentioned in the other capital, that will be the final one. Beyond that, no company is supposed to issue the shares. This is authorized capital. Then second one is issued capital. Here, you see, authorized capital. Suppose I have 1 lakh shares. Each share value is supposed to. That means now my authorized capital is 10 lakhs. That means totally I wanted to start my business with 10 lakhs. So that is to be divided in terms of 1 lakh shares at the rate of 10. Now out of this 1 lakh shares, suppose I am issuing only 60,000 shares only to the public, right? It's not mean that once I am having 1 lakh shares in my hand, so there is no rule that I have to issue all the shares at a moment. Out of this 1 lakh, right now I am issuing only 60,000 shares to the public. That means now 60,000 into 10, this is equal to 6 lakhs, it is the amount of issued capital. Then third one, it is subscribed capital. Subscribed capital means here I issue 60,000, but I may get the applications only for 55,000. Suppose this is subscribed. That means this is nothing but the response came from the public. Whatever the response coming for my company, that is nothing but the subscribed. Of course, if subscribed capital, it is again divided into two types. Subscribed fully paid. Subscribed but not fully paid. What do you mean by subscribed fully paid and subscribed but not fully paid? Suppose out of this 55,000, X is one of the shareholder having suppose one of the shares, and Y having say 2,000 shares. Now, actually the share value is 10. Suppose X paid all the 10 rupees on his 1,000 shares. Now, this is considered fully paid. Whereas Y is having 2,000 shares, but suppose he paid only 9 out of 10. Though the company is calling to pay 10 rupees, but he paid only 9 rupees on account of different reasons. Now this one, now Y's status is comes under subscriber but not fully paid. And one more classification also there, which is not that much important to the revenue balance sheet, called capital. So these are the different types of capitals. That means authorized capital. So in the balance sheet, one has to show authorized capital, issued capital, as well as subscribed capital. Then how to show this capital in the balance sheet? That is nothing but disclosure of capital in the balance sheet. Disclosure of capital in the balance sheet.